Family and friends, top of the day, it's Monday, and it's time for some motivation. A Beautiful Mind is a 2001 film starring Academy and Golden Globe winner Russell Crowe. He's most notable for his role as Maximus in the epic drama Gladiator.
Are you not entertained? Are you not entertained? Is this not why you are here?
Crowe's role in A Beautiful Mind was to illustrate the life of American mathematician John Nash. The movie is a great depiction of a beautiful mind. John Forbes Nash was born on June 13, 1928 in Bluefield, West Virginia. As a child, he took advanced mathematics courses before attending Carnegie Institute of Technology, which later became Carnegie Mellon University in 1967. Initially majoring in chemical engineering, he switched to chemistry before eventually graduating with both a bachelor's and master's degree in mathematics. Nash accepted a fellowship to Princeton University, where he furthered his education in mathematics and sciences. It's important to note that Nash was accepted to Harvard, but the chairman at Princeton offered the John S. Kennedy Fellowship to win him over. While at Princeton, Nash began working on his equilibrium theory, later known as the Nash Equilibrium. In 1950, Nash wrote a 28-page dissertation on non-cooperative games, the game theory. His contributions earned him the Nobel Memorial Prize in Economic Sciences in 1994. Beginning in the 1960s, economists were able to successfully apply the game theory to real-life situations. They used these practices with mergers, strikes, and protests, along with collective bargaining. His work was very helpful with issues that involve conflict and cooperation, the core of practical economics. I'm talking about international trade, auction, farm subsidies, and monetary policies were all seen as strategic games. You can even include the lottery. Check out my earlier video on wasted paper. Stay with me. Out of all of Nash's accomplishments, his most important battle was with mental health. Nash described his process of change from scientific rationality to delusional thinking as characteristics of a person diagnosed with schizophrenia. Nash saw himself as a messenger. He believed he had opponents and hidden schemers. Due to his erratic behavior and stress, his wife Alice filed for divorce in 1963. For the next 40 years, Nash struggled with mental illness and had numerous stays at treatment facilities. After re-entering into a relationship in the 1990s, Nash and ex-wife Alice remarried in 2001. Throughout it all, Nash was able to overcome his illness as a schizophrenic and was eventually allowed to teach at Princeton again. Maybe you suffer from stress, anxiety, or depression. Maybe it's substance abuse or alcoholism. It can be an undiagnosed illness or just a noticeable difference in behavior. The main takeaway is to understand the power of the mind. The paradox of mental illness being both a gift and a curse seems to be an appropriate topic today. Think about it for a second. Do you know anyone with a beautiful mind? Happy to help. Make it a great day.